Good afternoon, and thank you for joining us in our celebration of the Lord's Supper. In a few moments, we shall begin this celebration, and like what we have mentioned in our previous email, we encourage you, and if you would like to do the ceremonial washing of the feet within your family, to prepare these materials with you, have them handy, because they will be celebrated immediately after the homily. So we'd like to encourage you, if you're going to practice the ceremonial washing of the feet within your family as part of your sharing in the liturgy, to please prepare the materials, because in a few moments we shall be commencing our liturgy. And immediately following the celebration of the Lord's Supper, we shall have the adoration as we would normally have before the altar of repose, but this time an opportunity for us to continue in our prayer and reflection accompanying our Lord during this time as we begin the Easter Triduo.
Amen. O God, who called us to participate in this most sacred supper, in which your only begotten Son, when about to hand himself over to death, entrusted to the Church a sacrifice new for all eternity, the banquet of his love, grant, we pray, that we may draw from so great a mystery the fullness of charity and of life. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Genesis. The Lord said to Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt, "This month shall stand at the head of your calendar. You shall reckon it the first month of the year. Tell the whole community of Israel, on the 10th of this month, every one of your families must procure for itself a lamb, one apiece for each household. If a family is too small for a whole lamb, it shall join the nearest household in procuring one and shall share in the lamb, in proportion to the number of persons who partake of it. The lamb must be a year-old male and without blemish. You may take it from either the sheep or the goats. You shall keep it until the 14th day of this month. And then, with the whole assembly of Israel present, it shall be slaughtered during the evening twilight. They shall take some of its blood and apply it to the two doorposts and the lintel of every house in which they partake of the lamb. That same night, they shall eat its roasted flesh with unleavened bread and bitter herbs. This is how you are to eat it: with your loins girt, sandals on your feet, and your staff in hand, you shall eat like those who are in flight. It is the Passover of the Lord. For on this same night, I will go through Egypt, striking down every firstborn of the land, both man and beast, and executing judgment on all the gods of Egypt. I, the Lord. But the blood will mark the houses where you are. Seeing the blood, I will pass over you. Thus, when I strike the land of Egypt, no destructive blow will come upon you. This day shall be a memorial feast for you, which all your generations shall celebrate with pilgrimage to the Lord as a perpetual institution." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. Lectura de la primera carta del apóstol San Pablo a los Corintios. Hermanos, yo recibí del Señor lo mismo que les he transmitido, que el Señor Jesús, la noche en que iba a ser entregado, tomó pan en sus manos y, pronunciando la acción de gracias, lo partió y dijo: esto es mi cuerpo que se entrega por ustedes. Hagan esto en memoria mía. Lo mismo hizo con el cáliz después de cenar, diciendo: este cáliz es la nueva alianza que se sella con mi sangre. Hagan esto en memoria mía siempre que beban de él. Por eso, cada vez que ustedes comen de este pan y beben de este cáliz, proclaman la muerte del Señor hasta que vuelva. Palabra de Dios. Te alabamos, Señor.
Before the feast of Passover, Jesus knew that his hour had come to pass from this world to the Father. He loved his own in the world, and he loved them to the end. The devil had already induced Judas, the son of Simon of the Iscariot, to hand him over. So during supper, fully aware that the Father had already put everything into his power, and that he had come from God, and was returning to God, he rose from supper and took off his outer garments. He took a towel, tied it around his waist. Then he poured the water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and dry them with the towel around his waist. He came to Simon Peter, said to him, "Master, are you going to wash my feet?" Jesus answered and said to him, "What I am doing you do not understand now, but you will understand later." Peter said to him, "You will never wash my feet." Jesus answered him, "Unless I wash you, you will have no inheritance with me." Simon Peter said to him, "Master, then not only my feet, but my hands and my head as well." Jesus said to him, "Whoever has bathed has no need except to have his feet washed, for he is clean all over. So you are clean, but not all." For he knew who would betray him. For this reason, he said, "Not all of you are clean." So when he had washed their feet and put his garments back on, reclining at table again, he said to them, "Do you realize what I have done for you? You call me teacher and master, and rightly so, for indeed I am. If I, therefore, the master and teacher, have washed your feet, you ought to wash one another's feet. I have given you a model to follow, so that as I have done for you, you should also do." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
There's a passage from Scripture that really resonates with my priesthood and with just me as a person. From Matthew chapter 20, verse 28, we read, "The Son of Man has not come to be served, but to serve, and to give his life as a ransom for many." There's another similar passage from Scripture from Philippians chapter 2, verse 6. It says this: "Although he was in the form of God, Jesus did not deem equality with God something to be grasped at. Rather, he emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, being born in the likeness of men." The entire life and ministry of Jesus is about self-sacrificial love, self-sacrificial service, even to the point of death. La vida y el ministerio de Jesús están centrados en un servicio y un amor sacrificial hasta el punto de la muerte. We see this service and this sacrifice in his preaching of the gospel, in all of the miracles that he worked. And today, in a marvelous way, when he washes the feet of his disciples, and today, in Holy Thursday, when he institutes the Eucharist, his body, his blood, his soul, his divinity, and at the same time gives to us the ministerial priesthood so that this Eucharist can be perpetually done and sacrificed from the time of Jesus until today, 2,000 years later. And finally, tomorrow, his ultimate act of service and sacrifice, when he dies for us on the cross. When Jesus took the punishment that was due to us for our sins, we deserve death, but Jesus, in his great love, descended from heaven, taking the form of a slave, as we hear in Philippians. And instead of us dying on the cross, he died on the cross for us. El servicio, el sacrificio y amor de Jesús, lo podemos ver en su predicación, en sus milagros, y especialmente hoy día, cuando Jesús lavó los pies de sus discípulos. Cuando nos dio la Eucaristía, su cuerpo, su sangre, su alma, su divinidad, y cuando nos dio el sacerdocio para que podamos tener la misa y la Eucaristía desde el principio de la Iglesia hasta hoy, 2000 años después. In the past several weeks, we have seen tremendous service from all kinds of people from all across the world. Doctors, nurses, volunteers, grocery workers, delivery carriers, UPS, Amazon, world leaders, government leaders, families and friends, sacrificing and serving one another. This is how it's supposed to be. This is how we imitate the sacrificial love of Jesus Christ. On the other hand, at the same time, how can we deny that sometimes we fail in that love towards one another? Sometimes we can be selfish, or sometimes we can be like James and John in the Gospel, who want to be not servants, but the first in the kingdom of God. And Jesus says to us the same words that he says to James and John. Whoever would be great among you must be your servant. Whoever would be first among you must be your slave. You see, the Christian life is not about power. The Christian life is not about honor. It's not about prestige. It's about self-emptying love and service. La vida de un cristiano, un católico, no es hacer del poder o no las cosas del mundo. Es acerca de amor y servicio. Durante el curso de esta pandemia, lo hemos visto, este sacrificio de tantas personas. Y por eso estamos muy agradecidos. Pero a la vez, tenemos que reconocer que a veces fallamos en nuestro servicio, fallamos en nuestro amor, y por eso nos tenemos que arrepentir. Many of you are watching this Mass, this homily, at home right now, live, or maybe playback. While we're at home, it doesn't mean that our service stops. It doesn't mean that it decreases. In fact, now more than ever is when our service should increase. We should look for opportunities to serve one another. Parents serving your children, children serving the parents, couples loving and serving one another, brothers and sisters serving one another. This is when we get creative and grow in our service, not decrease in our service. We don't need to be out and about necessarily to serve. We can serve the people that are right in front of us. Durante este tiempo, no necesitamos salir de nuestras casas para servir a los demás. Podemos servir a las personas que están en nuestras casas. Padres sirviendo a sus hijos, hijos sirviendo a sus padres. A las parejas sirviéndose unos a otros, hermanos sirviendo unos a otros. Es durante este tiempo que crecemos en nuestro servicio, no bajamos. So today, on this Holy Thursday, when Jesus washes the feet of his disciples, when he gives us the Eucharist, when he institutes the priesthood, we decide to imitate him in our self-sacrificial love for one another. And this is what it means to be a disciple of Jesus Christ. Hoy día decidimos seguir a Cristo en su amor y en su sacrificio. Y vamos a amar a nuestra familia, a nuestro prójimo, a nuestra casa durante este tiempo. Eso es lo que significa ser un discípulo de Cristo. At this moment, normally we would have the washing of the feet, the liturgy of the washing of the feet, but of course, we're here in an empty church. It's just the priest here, deacon, and the two members of our choir. And as you have read in the email or the Facebook, Father Thomas has asked us to prepare materials for our foot washing in our homes. So now is the moment to prepare all of your materials, or if you haven't yet, and to begin this liturgy of washing the feet inside your very homes. You might start with the older members of your family washing the feet of the others, parents washing their children's feet first, for example, and then the opposite, the children washing the feet of their parents. So I'd just like to invite you to do that now, and we'll take a few minutes to do that.
Oh,
In remembrance, we gather. In humility, we look to God. In confidence, we pray for the church.
Thank you.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries. For whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the true and eternal Shepherd who instituted the pattern of an everlasting sacrifice and was the first to offer himself as the sitting victim, commanding us to make this offering as his memorial. As we eat this flesh that was sacrificed for us, we are made strong. And as we drink his blood that was poured out for us, we are washed clean. And so with the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end, we acclaim.
Sanctus, Sanctus.
Remember, Lord, all gathered here, whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. Celebrating the most sacred day, on which our Lord Jesus Christ was handed over for our sake, and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas, and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things we may be defended by your protecting help.
Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, which we make to you as we observe the day on which our Lord Jesus Christ handed on the mysteries of his body and blood for his disciples to celebrate. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O Lord, we pray, to bless and acknowledge and approve this offering in every aspect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your beloved Son,
our Lord Jesus Christ.
For on the day he was to suffer, for our salvation and the salvation of all that is today, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you.
In humble prayer, we ask the Almighty God command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high and in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at this altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing.
Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with a sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias Barnabas, Ignatius Alexander, Marcellinus Peter, Felicity Perpetua, Agatha Lucy, Agnes Cecilia Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord.
Through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, and by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other this sign of peace.
Peace be with you.
Miserere nobis.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Let us pray. Grant, Almighty God, that just as we are renewed by the supper of your Son in this present age, so we may enjoy his banquet
for all eternity, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
We take a moment now to pray to our loving Mother Mary. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. And may God rebuke you, we humbly pray. And to the whole Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, cast unto hell Satan and all evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank Diana and Andre for joining with us. And let us pray for them, because they also have children of their own, so that they may be protected. And God may always be with them. We shall now have the exposition and prayers in a few moments as we reflect on these few words of the song leading us to accompany our Lord Jesus as we begin our Easter retreat.
Thank you. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
For the growth of faith, hope, and charity, hail the grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be. Amen.
O my Jesus, forgive us our sins,
save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of thy mercy.
As we continue our reflection on the beginning of the Easter Triduum, especially as we have celebrated the Eucharist, the Last Supper, and the institution of the priesthood, we shall reflect on the luminous mysteries. The first luminous mystery is the baptism of our Lord Jesus in the river. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women,
and lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of thy mercy. The second luminous mystery is Jesus' revelation of himself at the wedding in Cana.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Almighty Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those who most need of thy mercy.
The fourth luminous mystery is the transfiguration of our Lord Jesus at Mount Tabor.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those who most need of thy mercy.
The last luminous mystery is the institution of our Lord Jesus Christ of our celebration of the Eucharist. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us
us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven.
Spare us, O Lord.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. and Sister Guido. You inspired Jesus, that the source of life gushed forth for souls, and the ocean of mercy opened up for the whole world. O fount of life, unfathomable divine mercy, open the whole world and empty yourself out upon us. O blood and water, which gush forth from the heart of Jesus, Father, I offer you the body and blood, soul and divinity of your dearly beloved
mercy on us and not the whole world.
Eternal God, in whom mercy is endless and the treasury of compassion inexhaustible, look kindly upon us and increase your mercy in us, that in difficult moments we may not despair nor become despondent, but with great confidence submit ourselves to your holy will, which is love and mercy itself.
Amen.
Jesus, King of mercy,
I trust in you.
Jesus, King of mercy,
I trust in you.
Jesus, King of mercy,
I trust in you.
And now we shall pray the Litany of Supplication, the same litany that our beloved Pope Francis prayed with the whole world during his Urbi et Orbi blessing. The response is, we adore you, O Lord. True God and true man, truly present in this holy sacrament,
we adore you, O Lord.
Our Savior, God with us, faithful and rich in mercy,
we adore you, O Lord.
King and Lord of creation and history,
we adore you, O Lord.
Conqueror of sin and death,
we adore you, O Lord.
Friend of humankind, risen and living at the right hand of the Father,
we adore you, O Lord.
The response will be, we believe in you, O Lord. Only begotten Son of the Father, who descended from heaven for our salvation,
we believe in you, O Lord.
Heavenly Doctor, who inclines over our misery,
we believe in you, O Lord.
Sacrifice Lamb, who offers himself to save us from evil,
we believe in you, O Lord.
Good Shepherd, who gives his life for the flock he loves,
we believe in you, O Lord.
Living bread and medicine of immortality, who gives us life eternal,
we believe in you, O Lord.
The response will be, free us, O Lord, from the power of Satan and the seductions of the world.
Free us, O Lord.
From pride and from the presumption that we can do without you.
Free us, O Lord.
From the distress of fear and anguish.
Free us, O Lord.
From unbelief and despair.
Free us, O Lord.
From hardness of heart and the incapacity to love.
Free us, O Lord.
The response will be, save us, O Lord, from all the evils that afflict humanity.
Save us, O Lord.
From hunger, famine, and egoism.
Save us, O Lord.
For disease, pandemics, and the fear of our brothers and sisters.
Save us, O Lord.
From devastating folly, from merciless interests, and from violence.
Save us, O Lord.
From deception, misinformation, and manipulation of consciences.
Save us, O Lord.
The response will be, console us, O Lord. Look upon your church, which is crossing the desert.
Console us, O Lord.
Look upon humanity, terrified by fear and anguish.
Console us, O Lord.
Look upon the sick and dying, oppressed by loneliness.
Console us, O Lord.
Look upon doctors and health workers overwhelmed by fatigue.
Console us, O Lord.
Look upon politicians and administrators who bear the weight of decisions.
Console us, O Lord.
The response will be, give us your Spirit, O Lord. In the hour of trial and confusion,
give us your Spirit, O Lord.
In temptation and in weakness,
give us your Spirit, O Lord.
In the battle against evil and sin,
give us your Spirit, O Lord.
In the search for true good and true joy,
give us your Spirit, O Lord.
In the decision to remain in you and in your friendship,
give us your Spirit, O Lord.
The response will be, open us to hope, O Lord. If sin oppresses us,
open us to hope, O Lord.
If hate closes our hearts,
open us to hope, O Lord.
If suffering visits us,
open us.
If indifference distresses us,
open us to hope, O Lord.
If death annihilates us,
open us to hope, O Lord.
Jesus, remember me.
Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom.
our continuing desire to accompany our Lord Jesus as we begin the Easter Triduum, we shall now have a reflective prayer and meditation on the stations of the cross led by Father Martin and Deacon Ben.
Were you there when they crucified?
The second station, Jesus accepts his cross. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you,
because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
Jesus Christ submitted entirely to the will of the Father, and so when he was given a rough cross to carry to his own execution, he embraced it. In some depictions, he even kisses the cross. He knew that the cross meant suffering, torture, and death. But he trusted his Father and knew that God brings good from every evil, even an evil as terrible as the cross.
Lord Jesus, pandemic is a hard cross to accept. Who will get sick? Who will die? Who will lose their job? How will this reshape the future? The only way to accept it is to trust, as you did, that the Father's care will never end. Give us this trust.
The third station, Jesus falls for the first time. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you,
because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
Jesus fell under the weight of the cross, under the weight of our sins, and we are horrified to see it. We repent what we did that led to this. First, we repent of the way we sin with our pride and greed. We lived a complacent life filled with selfishness. We ran up debts to please ourselves and impress the world instead of saving for an uncertain future. We put other gods in the center of our lives instead of the one true God.
Lord Jesus, you do not directly cause suffering, but you allow it because in your power and mercy, you can bring good out of it. Help us remember in this pandemic that we are not the center of the universe. You are. We repent of our pride and greed. May we put our time, effort, and resources where our heart truly is, with you.
The fourth station, Jesus meets his mother. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
Here is Jesus, face to face with his mother. When he was a baby, she was told that a sword would pierce her heart. From the cross, he will make her our mother. In between, she has had to walk a rough road with her son. But as they gaze at each other, the love the two have is so deep and sweet, all of that is forgotten.
Lord Jesus, if we did not know before, the pandemic reveals what your mother knew so well. This world is a veil of tears. Thank you for the gift of your mother, and thank you for your fidelity to the loving concern for us she brings to you.
The fifth station, Simon helps Jesus carry his cross. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
A passerby, Simon of Cyrene, is compelled by the Romans to help Jesus carry his cross. He stands for the corporal works of mercy, serving the physical needs of others, feeding the hungry, clothing the sick, giving drink to the thirsty, sheltering the homeless, burying the dead, and above all right now, visiting prisoners and shut-ins and visiting the sick.
Lord Jesus, show us opportunities to directly help those who are suffering from the pandemic. Sometimes, like Simon, we have little choice but to help. Sometimes we must seek out those who need our assistance. Send us out, an army of Simons, to lighten the burdens around us.
The sixth station. Veronica wipes the face of Jesus. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
Ignoring the complaints of the Roman guards, Veronica reaches out to comfort Jesus, using her veil to wipe his face, and receiving his image there in return. She stands for the spiritual works of mercy, instructing the ignorant, admonishing sinners, forgiving offenses, counseling the doubtful, bearing wrongs patiently, and above all right now, comforting the afflicted and praying for the living and the dead.
Lord Jesus, when we reach out to the suffering, our efforts restore your image in others and imprint your face on our lives. Give us the words we need to give faith to the shaken and hope to the hurting.
The seventh station, Jesus falls a second time. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
The weight of our sins forces Jesus to scandalized by Jesus. We have allowed ourselves to become petty and superficial, feeding off the anger of the like-minded and rejecting the humanity of those with whom we disagree. We have rolled ourselves off into halls of mirrors, reflecting our own image, where your truth can no longer penetrate.
Lord Jesus, it took a pandemic for us to see that we are your creatures, struggling to find our way in the world. We repent of our habits of anger and envy. Teach us to see the dignity of everyone we meet and to listen and to respond to their lives with your love.
The eighth station, Jesus meets the woman of Jerusalem. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
Jesus faces the crowd of women who are weeping in sadness for his plight. But he says, do not weep for me, but weep for yourselves and for your children. The ultimate tragedy of Jesus' suffering is not the pain he endures, but the many people who will refuse to accept the offer of salvation that is the reason for his pain.
Lord Jesus, help us see in this pandemic not just the tragedy of human suffering, but the tragedy of human souls. Help us to weep not just for the difficulty the world faces, but for the sins the world commits. We offer you the only consolation you want. Our lives offered back to you.
The ninth station. Jesus falls a third time. One last time, even as the end is in sight, Jesus falls once again into the dirt. This time he is knocked down by our sins of sloth and lust. Here he struggles up Calvary for us, but we so often cannot be bothered to do even the minimum for him. He calls us to greatness. We want only comfort. He offers his body to the Father. We pamper our bodies. We realize in horror that he died for the very people whose bodies we have treated as objects for our pleasure. Lord Jesus, in this pandemic, we repent of our sloth and lust. As those around us suffer sickness, economic hardship, and death, give us the purity of heart to see the true worth of everyone we meet, to repent of our past sins, and to honor and defend your image in others. The tenth station, Jesus is stripped of his clothing. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
Jesus goes to his Father as he came into the world. He has no fine clothes, no mighty airs. He is stripped bare before God and man, with nothing to hide his scars and pain, showing the whole world that, while yes, Jesus Christ is fully God, he is also fully human. He is one of us. Lord Jesus, this pandemic has stripped us of our illusions. We were like the emperor with no clothes, putting on airs and ignoring our real predicament, imagining that we were invincible. May we learn from you to see ourselves humbly and honestly, stripped of preconceptions, and to see that our true worth is that we are loved by one as great as you. The 11th station, Jesus is nailed to the cross. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
Here is the last torture of the mighty King. He is pinned helpless to a cross. The hands that created the universe clutch at the heads of nails. The feet that walked on water stream blood onto a wooden block. Lord Jesus, the pandemic has left us feeling helpless in front of the awful reality of suffering and pain. We are helpless to avoid the suffering that keeps coming, pinned to the cross of circumstance. But when we are most helpless, we find you embracing us. The 12th station, Jesus dies on the cross. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross, you have redeemed the world.
And then it happens, the unthinkable. The last cries of anguish, the commission of his spirit to God, and then the mighty head that spoke such beautiful words falls silent and limp. The king has died. This is a greater fear than any we could have imagined, and it is suddenly all too real. Jesus Christ, the second person of the Trinity, is dead on a cross. Lord Jesus, none of us knows what we face in this pandemic. We fear the worst. We fear death. For some of us, that fear will be realized. But you have yourself suffered the thing that is our greatest fear, to reassure us that even if you call us there, we will find you waiting, filled with love. The 13th station, Jesus is taken down from the cross. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross, you have redeemed the world.
The pain stops at last, when Jesus has given the full measure of love. He has carried the burden. He has been pushed and prodded and driven to his death. There at the end of the road, his body ends where it began, in the loving embrace of his mother. Lord Jesus, we have a long road ahead of us in this pandemic. We will walk it to the end, and though we do not know what we will find, we will walk it with faith, and we will never give up, knowing that every road leads to you. The 14th station, Jesus is buried. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by your holy cross, you have redeemed the world.
In the end, Jesus is buried in a cave, and a rock is pushed across the mouth of the tomb. He is left to rot. So often, the world has done the same thing, hidden Jesus away, sealed him off from polite society, and given up on his love. But our Lord will not decompose in the tomb. He will rise again and will make himself present in the sacraments of the Church. Baptism, confession, the Eucharist, confirmation, our marriages, holy orders, and the sacrament of the sick. Lord Jesus, so often the world has counted you down and out, but you always rise again. In this time of pandemic, we pray for the physical cure our bodies need, but thank you with all our heart for the spiritual cure that you gave us on Easter. May our present suffering lead us to love you even more in your sacrament. Lord Jesus, these are such painful and difficult times. We have walked your way of the cross with you, remembering your sacrifice. Now we ask that you walk our way of the cross with us, filling our lives with your love. We know that whatever comes, the future is safe in your hands.
Good night.